Hi, welcome to Walk Into Dotin. In this short video, I am going to show how to create navigation menus for a Walk Into tour. In this tour, I will be showing you how to use the menu tool on the left as well as the shortlist tool, which is on your right top here. The shortlist tool has just captured a bunch of viewpoints that I would like to use in my menu creation. It's a very handy tool. That takes you exactly where you want to go, and we have another video that detailing out how to use that tool to the full extent. Let's start. To create a new menu, what we need to do is click on the add new icon. This will create a new menu item in the main menu structure. When we are creating a menu, let it be a main menu or a sub menu, we are doing two things. One is naming it as well as setting what should be the viewpoint the user sees when the user clicks on that menu. So here I can turn the panorama to exactly the viewport I would like to use. I can use the zoom buttons, I can use the panning, and then click on save to save it correctly. To create another menu item, all we need to do is repeat the same steps, which is clicking on the add menu, naming it rightly, turning the viewport to the view I want to use, and clicking on save. Creating a submenu is extremely easy too. The plus button on the right creates a submenu for me. I can name it the way I want. And here I am going to show you how to use the shortlist tool to pick a panorama that I have already shortlisted for this particular menu item. Clicking on the shortlist tool brings up the shortlist navigation window on my right corner, and using the navigation arrows, I can go to the view I would like to use and click on the select button to bring up the panorama and click on save, and that's all I need to do to save a new submenu item. Adding the plus again creates another submenu for me. And remember that we do not control the menu structure for any of the tools that you would like to use. It can be as big, as deep as you would like it to be right. Big complicated menus can confuse the user. So we recommend using about 5 menus at the most on each of the levels if you would like to have. And also in this beta version, we have a limitation with respect to the length of the menu. The length of the menu doesn't scroll nicely. So we recommend you use a short menu at each levels and use submenus as you would like to have. Hope you enjoyed this video.